नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। दिस इज जेवीएन डॉक्टर विशाल सिन्हा, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन मैथमेटिक्स, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मॉड्यूल इंटीग्रेशन एंड इंटीग्रल फंक्शंस, इंटीग्रल प्रोसेस। सो दिस मॉड्यूल इज अ पार्ट ऑफ द कोर्स एलिमेंट्री मैथमेटिक्स running under the various courses of the university. Integration is the calculation of an integral. So integration, what is integration? First we see, integration is the calculation of the integral. Integrals in maths are used to find many useful quantities such as areas, volumes, displacement, etc. When we speak about integrals, it is related to usually defined definite integrals. The indefinite integrals are used for anti-derivatives. So mainly this we have seen here, the indefinite integrals are the anti-derivatives, while the definite integrals are used to find various things like areas, volumes, displacement and other parts. Integration definition. The integration denotes the summation of discrete data. The integral is calculated to find the function which will describe the area, displacement, volume that occurs due to a collection of small data which cannot be measured singularly. In a broad sense, in calculus, the idea of limit used where algebra and geometry are implemented. Next, we take the part of the definite integral and indefinite integral. So first, we take definite integral. An integral that contains the upper and the lower limits, then it is a definite integral on a real line. X is restricted to lie. Riemann integral is the other name of the definite integral. A definite integral is represented by just integration, lower limit is a and upper limit is b, fx dx. So definite integral consists of the limits lower and upper for a function fx, while indefinite integral indefinite integrals are defined without upper and lower limits. It is represented as integration of fx dx is equal to fx plus c. Just we have seen here integration of fx, where fx is small fx, and just it is equal to fx plus c, where c is any constant and the function fx is called the integrand. So fx is the integrand, and this integration is the reverse process of the differentiation. Now integration formulas. Check below the formulas of integral or the integration which are commonly used in higher level maths calculations. So using these formulas you can easily solve any problems related to integration. So these are the basic formulas of integral, like integration of 1 is x plus c, where c is constant of integration and c is always used for the indefinite integral. Integral of a dx is equal to ax plus c, a is constant so it is taken out from the integral, and integral of dx is x. Integration of the x to the power n is equal to x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 plus c. Integration of sin x is minus cos x. Integration of cos x is minus sin x plus c. Integration of sec square x dx is equal to tan x plus c. Integration of cos x square x is minus cot x plus c. Integration of sec x tan x is equal to sec x plus c, and so on. So these are the various basic formulas of integration, and with the help of these integral formulas we can determine the integrals. Now we take some examples of integration. So first example, find the integral of the function 0 to 3 x square dx. So this is the integration which is definite integral because it consists of the limit term. So how can we solve? Just we have to integrate x square with the help of x to the power n, from the integration of x to the power n, and it is given by x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So integral of x square is x to the power 3 upon 3 under the limit 0 and 3. So this can be solved as 3 is like 9, no? It is 3 to the power 3 upon 3 minus 0 to the power 3 upon 3, and ultimately after solving it becomes 9. Now one more example of integration we take, find the integral of the function x square without limit here. So just we can see it is integral of x square, and then we can solve by the basic formula x to the power n. So which is equal to integration of x to the power n is equal to x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So it becomes x to the power 3 upon 3 plus c. C is taken here because just we have seen here it is a indefinite integral. This session is powered by Digital Version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope all you are satisfied with the digital session. If you have any query, please mention in the comment box. I will resolve your doubts and problems. Thank you.